BMF has got a very rich heritage with the current affairs. You know, I mean, it's 20 years down the line, BMF had a particular philosophy, which has not really changed. The corporate strategy is a blueprint of the organization. It must be written in some format. And that's something that I'm looking at to say that maybe going forward, the BMF needs a very concrete written 3-year to 5-year strategy with all those three pillars that I've articulated. I've always wanted to contribute to change, and when I looked at the Black Management Forum, I realized, well, this is obviously an organization, as I said, you don't have a lot of constraints in terms of legislation, so you can walk into an organization and then start having a conversation about economic transformation without necessarily offending the respective part, you know. So and BMF has those capabilities, you know. So that is probably the one probable reason that made me to apply for the position. But by and large, it's also, I mean, if you look at my track record, I've always been an individual who wants to see an impact on people.
The emphasis was coming to the BMF to see how we can help to galvanize this important organization to reach its stated objectives of being one, an organization that's really responsible for the development of managerial leadership, primarily but not exclusively amongst Black people. And then number two, of course, standing for socio-economic transformation. And for us, we understood transformation to mean breaking with the past and fundamentally changing the order of things. You see, at the BMF, our understanding of leadership is simply an absolute obsession with the development of others. And we compare and contrast that with management, where management, our understanding is that is the effectiveness and efficiency in climbing the corporate ladder of success. So management is self-centered, leadership is the other-centered. Management has to do with what happens when you are there. Leadership has to do with what happens when you are not there. Leadership begs the question as to whether the corporate ladder is leading against the correct wall to start off with. So for us, we have always understood leadership to be central, indeed center stage, to everything that we do. Why? Because we wanted people to produce superior business outcomes. So we wanted that type of animal, this progressive manager, who always remembers where they come from, what has shaped them, and will do three things. One, to be absolutely obsessed with embarrassingly good results at work, while still married to their lifelong partners, and still make time to invest in their communities that made them to be who they are. Because this thing called the world of work is inimical to good, close, personal, intimate relationships, and indeed with families. When you invest in the continent of Africa, the return on investment is 30 to 45%, compared to 5 to 7% in the US and indeed in Europe. Instead of saying, in most developed markets, most people already have houses, they have cars and white goods. But in Africa is the land of opportunity. So if you're looking for real growth, you should be looking at 1 billion people that are in Africa. Because 1 in 2 people in the world do indeed live in China, India, and Africa.